Okay, so for omega equal to omega r, to the resonant frequency, of course, on the phasor plot here, voltage and current are in phase, and current in the resistor are in phase, of course, and currents in capacitor and in inductor have the same magnitude but opposite phases. Okay, so they cancel. And that's another way of looking at the resonance. Okay, in this circuit at least, because we have two reactive components. One is inductive and the other is capacitive. Then of course they have opposite expressions for impedance, and those, and they both imaginary, and for an inductor and capacitor, they will, if they have the same amplitude, they cancel. Okay, so they disappear, and IL plus IC becomes zero. So we have, in time domain, that's how these currents look like. So here you see the capacitor and inductor current canceling, being exactly in opposite phases. Now, of course, as you go to lower frequencies, when omega is less than omega r, these two vectors don't add up to zero. So the current in capacitor and inductor are not in antiphase. I mean, they are in antiphase, but they have different amplitude. So there will be a vector which will not be lying on the horizontal axis. So we used a simple vector geometry to obtain the phases. The thing goes above the axis here when we go to omega r, omega greater than omega r. But the main, most important diagram is the middle one. Okay? When you see the resonance, you should really understand that this is the essence of the resonance. Both imaginary values of impedances cancel. They have the same magnitude, but opposite phase. So what remains is purely resistive. When you look at resonant circuits, you very often see in literature something that is called the quality factor, or Q factor, or simply Q. It's quite a difficult definition, really, to apply to a general circuit, but it simplifies quite considerably if you just look at pure RLC, both parallel and series, as we look at it later. But in general, the quality factor is defined by the ratio of energies. Because what actually happens in resonance, which is another thing that it's useful to understand, is that ideal resistors and capacitors, the resonance simply means that the energy is being delivered from one element to the other. Okay, so the element, the energy in the purely in an ideal RLC circuit is delivered from the capacitor to the inductor and goes back again without any loss. Okay, so it can actually oscillate going backwards and forwards forever. That's ideally, of course, because in practice there is always some resistance, some radiation from the circuit, so the energy will eventually disappear. But ideally it will just go from one to the other forever. So it's the energy stored and energy lost per period that are actually that go into the quality factor. In an ideal resonance circuit with no losses, both energy stored and energy loss will be zero. Okay, so quality factor will be infinity. But because in real circuits there is a resistance, then every time the energy goes from capacitor to the inductor or vice versa, some of that energy is lost inside the resistor. Okay, so the maximum energy that is stored, of course, is the same for both inductor and capacitor, but the energy lost per period is finite, it's not zero, okay? It's greater than zero. So the ratio of these two energies multiplied by 2 pi for mathematical reasons, for reasons of just calculations later on, is called Q. So we won't go into maths here. You can study later if you were interested. But eventually, for a simple or pure parallel RLC circuit, the quality factor at resonance is equal to simply omega zero CR. So normally, quality factor is calculated around at or around the resonant frequency. Otherwise, it depends on frequency, so it's very difficult to calculate. It's a function of frequency. But normally, when we have resonant circuits, we are interested in their behavior near the frequency of resonance. So that's how we calculate it for RLC circuit. You can see here that for an ideal circuit, when ideal resonance circuit, Q0 should be infinity, and C is finite, of course. Otherwise, it doesn't make any sense at all. But R can be infinity, okay? If you remove R, that means that R is infinity in this circuit. It's a parallel connected R. So open circuit, no R, R is infinity. And you see that Q0 will indeed be infinity.